In the last section, we had a long discussion about the layout of our application as it stands right now. However, we didn't really get that much closer to write any code to get our box to actually center up on the screen. So to get our box to center on the screen, we're not going to actually change the box one bit. Instead, we're going to change the cat. So let's talk about exactly what we're going to do here and why we're going to do it. So the first thing I want to remind you is that at present, if we find our build cat animation method, that cat is being moved around on the screen through the use of a container. We have our container being created inside of our builder method, and on the margin property of the container, we are trying to change that margin on the top, and that is what is causing the box to move, or excuse me, the cat to move around. Now there's a very big downside to this approach now that we're using the stack widget. Let me show you what that downside is. Okay, so back inside over here, I'm gonna just click on the cat, and that's going to start our animation playing. And you'll notice that when the animation plays, the box actually moves as well. So let's think about what's happening right now. Back inside the stack class documentation, I want you to recall the stack is going to try to contain everything inside of it, and it's going to resize itself to contain everything inside. And so when we start to increase the margin of the container that is being displayed inside the stack, this margin right here is causing the container to increase in its overall size. And so we can now imagine that we are in a situation where we've got the image like down here, and the image has a ton of margin. Here, I'll put another thing right here. I'll call it margin. And it's got a ton of margin right above it. And so in total, the image is trying to take up this much height. Of course, the box, or the stack, the green thing right here, is going to try to resize its height to fit the total height of the image plus the margin above it. And so the stack starts to grow, and at all times our container is going to try to stick to that upper left-hand corner. And so essentially we can imagine that the margin starts off as very low when the animation first starts, so the container is like down there, and the margin starts to grow. The stack grows to match it, and so the margin keeps going, the stack keeps going up, and as both those change and the stack starts to increase in size, the container stays pinned to the top left-hand side. And so that's why we are seeing the container move around when the cat animation plays. So like I said, we're going to fix this not by changing the box, because the box is essentially doing the right thing. You know, it's moving around as we want it to do. We're going to instead fix it by changing the cat. And we're going to make the cat not affect the overall dimensions of our stack. That's the key. We don't want to change the dimensions of the stack, because if we change the dimensions of the stack, that's going to cause everything inside of it to move around. So in order to keep the cat from changing dimensions of the stack, all we have to do is turn the cat widget from a non-positioned widget into a positioned widget instead. When a widget is positioned inside the stack is not going to consider that position widget when it is trying to size itself. Okay, so that's the idea. We're going to find our cat right here. Rather than using a container, we're going to do something else to it to make it a positioned widget instead. So how do we make a position widget? Well, we just use this position class, that's it. So we're going to look up the documentation for positioned. The position widget is essentially a container that is specifically used inside of a stack. So we only use positioned when we are inside of a stack. And even the first sentence right here, only use position when it's a descendant of the stack. The position class is used to apply just a tiny little adjustment on the positioning of some widget inside the stack. You'll recall that when we were talking about our diagram back over here and initially saying, oh yeah, we want to use a stack because we want everything to be rendered on top of each other, we then said we're going to render everything on top of each other and then kind of like do little adjustments to get this flap to show up here, this flap to show up over here, and the cat to show up here. And so we're going to do those tiny little adjustments by using that positioned class. So we're going to use this to kind of very slightly move stuff around. Okay, so essentially to fix all this layout stuff, all we have to do is say rather than using a container to position our cat, we're going to use a positioned class instead. So inside of build cat animation, I'm going to find where we make our container, and I'm going to replace it with positioned. like so. Now, a position widget does not have any margin assigned to it. If we go back over to the position documentation and then look at the constructor right here, when we create a positioned element, we can pass in essentially like left spacing, top, right, and bottom spacing as well. And so that's what we're going to do to apply some movement to our cat. We're just going to change either the top or bottom positioning to kind of move it up and down the screen. So let's try doing that right now. I'll say that rather than trying to define a margin, so I'm going to delete that entire line. I'm going to replace it with, we can either do top or bottom. I don't know. Let's do bottom. What the heck? I'll say bottom. We're going to have an animation dot value, or excuse me, cat animation dot value, like so. So now, whenever our animation updates, we're going to rebuild positioned. It's going to have a new, essentially, offset of bottom. And this thing is going to position itself relative to the stack without attempting to change the dimensions of the stack. So let's now save this, and we'll do another quick test. So I'll do my refresh. Now remember, the other thing to keep in mind here is now that we're using positioned, the stack is not going to care about that cat one bit. So when we refresh right here, I see my box, but you'll notice that now it looks like the cat is not showing up at all. Okay, well, looks like we just traded one issue for another. So let's take another quick pause. We are going down the right path, I'll tell you that. We just have to add in one other little piece of code. So let's take a quick pause. We'll come back to the next section. We'll talk about why adding in position right here in place of container caused the image to essentially disappear. And we'll talk about how we're going to fix it as well. So quick break, and I'll see you in just a minute.